take the same as any other potatoes. You want to wash them.
Okay. How many should they have a potato per person?
You could say a potato per person if they're big potatoes. Get one like that. That's a pretty good sized potato.
Mm-hmm.
One per person would work. If you got a smaller one, I would do one and a half per person.
Okay.
While you're shredding your potatoes, you want to go ahead and preheat the stove. Just got a little bit of oil in the skillet.
Okay.
While you're shredding.
So guys, if I was going to make this and you wanted to make it, you could use pure vegetable oil, but if you wanted to make it a little healthier, you could always run for the classic olive oil. It's better for your veins and arteries and your heart. It's great for diabetics. They, in fact, suggest that or grapeseed oil. And a lot of times they will suggest, this one's a little out there, but avocado oil. I have yet to try both. I'm excited to get some and try each one and see what they taste like. If all else fails and you don't mind the taste, you can also use coconut oil. I heard that coconut oil in eggs is pretty good. So we're going to take each potato and you're going to just slice it.
Shred it.
Shred it.
You got a four-way peeler, shredder. You got all these different sizes. Mm-hmm. I use this side.
Awesome. Do they need to salt and pepper it?
I don't put any salt and pepper on it until after it's cooked.
Okay.
I cook it plain. That way, you know, you got some people that don't like it salt or pepper. Some like it more, some like it less. You can cook it the same. You can season it afterwards.
Now, once you get it in the pan, how long do you want to set those potatoes in there for?
I have never actually timed it. I always like to watch so you see it turn this little golden brown on the underside.
Okay.
You can usually see it coming around the side, this golden brown. Then when you flip it, about half the time that you had it in there before is how long it's going to be on once you flip it.
So, at this point, if you wanted to add salt and pepper, this would be the point you would add it.
No. You're going to go ahead and let it cook. Put it in there, you need to cook as it is.
Mm-hmm.
And then once it's done cooking, you can bring it to the table. Just after you turn it, you can see
it. You want a plate to set it in after to let it, the grease drain off? I mean, there's really no trick. I think at this point, if you wanted to add salt and pepper to your raw potatoes, you could, correct?
You could, yes.
Okay.
If you know definitively that's how you want it, you could. I've done it when I was cooking it for myself.
See his nice tattoos, guys? We're striving for that. Yeah. So basically, you're going to let it cook like that.
Mm-hmm.
And then when it gets golden, now how are you going to tell? Are you just going to take the spatula and kind of lift it?
It helps. You can usually see it around the sides here. In a couple minutes, it'll start turning a golden brown all over. You can particularly tell if there's any potatoes that are covered in the oil. You'll start to see it turn a little golden brown. That's when you get the spatula and you flip it. Otherwise, it helps if you can't tell.
Uh-huh.
Just try to pick it up with the spatula. If it still feels like it's going to fall apart, leave it. If it feels like it's got some consistency to it, you're either about there or you're ready to flip it.
Can you add onion to it if you wanted to also?
You could put probably just about anything in there you wanted.
See, I would probably add some onion just to see what it tasted like. I like onion and stuff, so I would probably shred up some onion and put it in mine. The best thing I would suggest after you're done cooking it and it's frying up, which we are also going to make a batch with onion in it, so I'll tell you guys later in my link below which one tastes better. You're going to want to have something set aside to let the grease drain out. So in this case, we're going to do that.